I'd also be making resolutions for the new year. But before we make these resolutions, let's consult our Lord. Let's consult God. And He will help us prepare them. Today I'm joined by my son, Desmond Peter. And he will come to you with a few scriptures and Matthew's, the 5th chapter. But before he do that, we would like to go to the throne of grace. Heavenly Father, we ask that you bless everyone who's doing this program today. Lord, we ask that you give them the desires of their heart. Lord, heal their bodies and touch their souls. Save the souls as they shall. Reclaim the backslider, revive them, give them. Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today, Desmond's going to be coming to you from Matthew, the 5th chapter. He's going to read a few verses. And then we're going to talk about what we've been doing.
Blessed are the poor in the spirit, for there is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall comfort. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy.
Amen. That was my son Desmond reading from Matthew's. We know as the new year comes, a lot of responsibility comes to us. Responsibilities and commitments. Exercise, bills, paying taxes, not to procrastinate, but just doing things that we started last year and didn't finish. But now we have new goals and new resolutions. So, I just want to inform the listeners about what we did at the ending of last year. I'm going to let Desmond talk about it, and then I will elaborate on a few things about what we did Christmas Day.
So basically, we like helped out other people in need. We like gathered bags of food and water and soap and all of that other stuff and packed it in bags and gave it to people in need that don't have the things that we got. And we just basically passed them out to people that's in need of these things.
Who are passing out there to?
It was me, my dad, my sister, my brothers.
What were their names?
Dominic, Jayla, and Shannon.
Okay, how long were we passing out treats or Christmas presents and so forth?
We were passing out for at least 2.5 hours. This is the second year that we have done this.
And why did we do this?
I'm and my brother, because he helped out people too.
What was his name?
His name was Chico Whitaker.
Yes. Okay. Desmond was basically telling you about a tradition we started a few years ago. It's called Christmas in the Streets. Now, Christmas in the Streets was basically started out of a mirror for my late son, Chico Jr. Garden. As I said once before, we was going to visit a young man, was in a shelter several years ago. And when we went to the shelter, we stopped on 3rd and Mac, and we talked to the individual that was there. My son also brought some pizza. And he only took a couple of slices out the box. And his friend was in the shelter. So he gave him three slices. And while we was talking to him and giving him a monetary gift, a young lady walked up to the van, which my son didn't even know. And she was hungry also. So she asked if she had some pizza. My son, being the kind-hearted individual that he is, after he took two slices off and gave his friend a few slices, he gave the young lady the rest of the pizza, which he didn't even know. And I thought that was a nice gesture and everything, you know, because the Bible said we should help others. So a few years ago, May the 20th, my son passed up on a heart attack. And usually he would be bubbly and bright-eyed and at our house every Christmas when we celebrate. And we would sing, take pictures, eat, and open gifts. So he wasn't there with us in 2017 when we started that tradition. But in honor of my son, we started the Christmas in the streets. 2017, we went from 8-9 in Greenfield all the way down to Eastland, passing out backpacks. The backpacks said, what in it, Desmond?
Yeah. Blankets and food and water and all that other stuff.
Yes. So, the first year we passed out 50 backpacks. And out of the backpacks, we had about 8 items. We had a couple of bottles of water. We had apples. We had sandwiches. We had Bibles. We had blankets. We had hats. We had gloves. We had socks. That was in the backpacks. Last year, 2018, we passed out about 36 backpacks and bags. And the areas that we went along was, last year we covered a different route. We wanted to cover the highways and overpasses. But we started over by the medical center, along the night. We passed our suburb in the Eastern Market. Where did we go from there, Denver? You know the statement?
Yeah, campus marshes are downtown.
And there were people downtown between campus marshes and High Rock Cafe. They were laying down with blankets or coats and stuff, and it was chilly. People were skating outside the campus marshes and other areas. We passed out about 8 bags along the fence across the street from campus marshes. Also, we hit over there by 7-Eleven and up along Jefferson and Greyhound bus terminal. And these people were elated to get something on Christmas. One individual was stopped at a gas station on Mac and Mount Hillary. And as we passed out the bags and everything, the individual asked me, could he have a gift card? I told him we didn't have no gift cards. So then he proceeded to ask me for a monetary gift. He said he needed some money to get home, so I gave him $2 because he had to catch the bus. But the previous year, 2017, my kids was out there from like 3 to 8, and it was snowing that year. Last Christmas, we didn't get much snow, but it was cold. But this is what the Christmas Day tradition is all about. Sacrifice, helping the less fortunate. Those are less fortunate than you are. I heard an individual say some time ago, how would you feel if someone came to your house and it was your birthday, and they ate up all your food, took plates on, and then bring a present. So, they wanted to equate that to Christmas and Christ. God gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. We don't know when Jesus was born. We hear that it was over 2,000 years ago through historians. Whether it was in the wintertime or the spring, we don't know. We wasn't around for that. But Jesus is the reason for the season. So, this is why we celebrate Christmas in the streets. Coming up, my mother raised six children, three boys and three girls. And she made sure that we would always have something for a holiday. Although she labored and sacrificed, when Christmas came along, there would be gifts up under the tree. And she worked entirely for us. She's gone home to be with the Lord. And this is how I enjoy Christmas, by helping those who are less fortunate. Not only do we do it during Christmas, we have a program that I started about 34 years ago, DHS. DHS stands for Detroit Hunger Society. And around Thanksgiving, we pass out turkeys. We've been doing it for a number of years without any sponsors. We help the less fortunate. Who would get a turkey? Those that was unemployed, senior citizens, veterans, or low income. It didn't matter. I like to say, we don't have any sponsors, but we need sponsors to help us with these projects. Every year, it gets bigger and bigger. And I just want to congratulate my children on taking time out of their schedule when other children were heading on playing or enjoying themselves. My children was out doing something to help those that are less fortunate. So I want to thank them for that. They could have been home in a warm bed or eating or doing something else. But this is a tradition we chose to do. And as long as the Lord provides energy and the resources, I will continue to do it. Sometimes it is hard, sacrificial, yes. But sometimes you just have to do what you feel is right. People will not always see your vision and support it. The longer you make a difference, when you're gone, other people can pick up the banner and make the time and do likewise. Anything you
want to add, Desmond? I mean, it's always good to help other people out, because you never know when you're down, and then you need help, and then you want to expect somebody to help you out.
Now, Desmond, I read the scriptures in Matthew, and it said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are they that meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for they shall. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. We know Jesus, and he walked around this earth in Jerusalem. Mary and Martha served him and everything. He also told his disciples that you have the poor, which you always. But just because we have the poor, we cannot look down on them. We cannot frown on them. Every day as we go to work, doctor's appointments, shopping, we see these people, whether they're veterans, senior citizens, homeless people, or runaways. They have signs on our freeways, on our streets, in our neighborhood, and they need a handout. Be bold enough to help them. Help someone that's less fortunate than you and see it that you feel the joy that it takes to accommodate these people. Who knows? One day this might be maybe one of your sons or daughters, and you don't want them to be in that predicament. So please help them. Also, while I'm here, I want to say thank you to my daughter, Shana. She presented a wonderful gift to me and my wife. Our anniversary was Christmas Eve, and my wife's birthday was the 17th of December. My daughter brought us a hotel package that we went to over the weekend. And the hotel package consists of a spa, a massage, a continental breakfast. There were several other things in that package that I don't remember at this time. But it sent her back a pretty penny. And I just want to thank Shannon, my daughter, that me and my wife was able to experience a second honeymoon. We enjoyed it. I mean, we just got back yesterday. So when we did get back, the kids went to get something to eat. And me and my wife took a ride in Bel Air. And while we were at Bel Air yesterday, I was marveled at what I seen at the beach. There was 8 men at the beach yesterday. They were holding hands. These was young gentlemen from the age of 17 to maybe 23. And these young men was holding hands, praying at the beach of Bel Air. Later on, 6 of them got in the water and they baptized themselves. Now, I had never seen nothing like this, where a young man baptized himself. Usually, it was a minister or a missionary, someone baptized them. But they went in the water, baptized themselves, got out and dried themselves, and went to the car and fellowship and had prayer. I wanted to take pictures and everything. And my wife said, no, don't do that. Nobody can say it. And in other words, I would be invading their property. But we stayed in the vehicle and watched that. And I thought that was commendable for young men to dedicate themselves to the Lord. Because we know in this society, some young men are out there robbing people, selling drugs, wearing their pants below the bottom, cussing people out for disrespecting one another. And these young men were making a commitment to the Lord. So I just want to thank them for what they were doing and everything, and hope that more people will follow. There's anything you want to say? And also, I have an announcement to make. I'd like to announce the past
conocer a Miss Lily Knight. A lot of you knew her from Lebanon Square on the east side. She made her demise today. The family has not yet gave out the information for her home dying. For those that know the Nunes family, keep them in prayer. Miss Lily Nunes made her transition home today. Funeral right now, our information is not available, but keep them in prayer. This year, Brandon Grayson celebrated their 11th anniversary. And there will be people that you see in the gospel entertainment industry or that you buy their records. You will be seeing some of their pictures and faces in the future. We're going to go after some of the top name artists in gospel. And hopefully, they will make a commitment to come on the air and tell you more about themselves. For all the churches that would like to advertise and be a part of this radio and TV family, please call the studio at 313-868-6612. That's 313-868-6612. And the station will be happy to put it together, a package for you. So you can broadcast on this station or have your radio program. But while you filling out your income tax and you have something to donate something to this station, WHPR, and also Growing in Grace. We would greatly appreciate it. Desmond, anything else going on? Like I said, if you're interested, if you're interested in getting the airtime or having your own show, call the studio at 868-6612. Also, the last month I had a procedure and I was in the hospital, and I know many of you prayed for me. I want to thank you for that. And so far, we hope that you have a happy and great new year this year. Hope everything that you set out to do will be successful. And I like to say, along the way, bless someone that needs a blessing. Help those that are less fortunate than you are. For Christ said, love your neighbors. So don't look down on trying to know about you. But do whatever you can to enrich their lives. I want to tell the young folks, if you have a grandmother, grandparent, or a relative in the nursing home, this year, try to visit them more. You have loved ones that's overseas or in the army, call them, write them. Or if you have to get on Facebook, just stay in touch with your loved ones and everything. Our country just spends a
unholy alliance, we need to pray more. The government is shut down in certain areas. But my Bible says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their land. The Lord promised to heal our land and forgive our sins. But America must repent. We must repent. Because we turned our face from God. Don't let him turn his blessings from us. Continue to seek his face. And he will give you the desires of your heart. Yes, in his closing statements.
I just want you to know to stay close to God, because you don't know when it's your time. And life is short, so stay grateful. Keep on asking for forgiveness.
I just want to add, if you want to stay clean, stay on God's team in 2019. Thank you. You've been watching Growing in Grace with your hosts, Chico and Desmond. Until next week, may God richly bless you. Amen.